Good morning, children. Today we shall deal with the topic decentralization in India. So you will be asked questions from here. What is decentralization? What is the need for decentralization? So such type of questions will be asked from here. So listen carefully to the topic and read your text also. Now we know, you all know that India is having diverse population, isn't it? So because of the diverse population in India, we are having a three-tier level of government. Already in smaller classes you had learned the different levels of government. Which are the different levels of government? You have learned levels of government as well as organs of government. Organs of government, if we say, they are legislature, executive and judiciary. Levels of government, if we say, they are central government, state government and the local government. Now you move on to the topic, what is decentralization? What do you mean by decentralization, or why do we have decentralization? Now decentralization means it is just opposite to centralization. So what is centralization? Centralization means more powers are being given to the central government. So decentralization means powers are being taken away from the central government as well as the state government and given to the third tier or third level of government, which you call as local government. So this system is called as decentralization. So what do you mean by decentralization? Decentralization means taking powers from the central government and state government and giving it to the local government is called as decentralization. So why do we have decentralization, or what is the need for having decentralization? Now luckily we people have a lot of political leaders, isn't it? So they realized, these political leaders, they realized the importance of decentralization, because India being a very big country and there are people living in small remote villages as well as towns also, and they also are citizens of India who need to get a vote. So there is and there are a large number of local problems also which are to be settled at local level. So many issues which arise at local level cannot be solved at a state level, because they may not be giving priority to the local problems. So usually, for example an issue of water, the need for a water tank in a village, it's a very big problem in a village, or it's a very much necessity for the people to have a water tank in a village. Now here the leaders of the concerned area can take a decision, but it may not be as much as important if this problem go to a state, because in a state there are lots of other problems that are to be solved. So some issues which are locally important may not be important if such problems are taken to the state level. So it is a must that problems have to be solved at the grassroots level itself. So for this purpose, people should be made aware and responsible to manage the problem of their localities and use the local resources also to solve such type of problems. So in such situations, people can directly participate in making decision, and thereby they can ensure a common rule related to people. So several amendments were being made, a lot of amendments. Amendment means what? Amendment means changes, isn't it? So a lot of changes were being made in the year 1992, and before 1992 everything was under the control of the central government and the state government. But it's after the amendment that was made in the year 1992, importance were given to Panchayati Raj and municipality. Now what are the amendments that were made in the year 1992? What is the priority of the amendment of 1992? So it was in the amendment of 1992 that it was made mandatory to hold regular elections in the local government, or regular elections have to be conducted in the local governments. Now another amendment made was that they introduced a special autonomous body which you call as election commission, mainly to conduct elections in the local level. That means in, that is in the panchayat as well as in the municipalities. I think you are all familiar with municipal elections. Now it under the amendment of 1992, it was made prior that to ensure every section of the society should be given importance. Seats were specially reserved for scheduled caste, scheduled tribes as well as the OBCs, and it was mandatory that 1/3 of the seats were reserved for women, and the state government were required to share some of the powers and revenue to the local governments, and the local government were given authority or power to use or to spend the money in the development of villages, towns as well as cities. Now moving on to a local government. Local government means it comprises of two, rural as well as urban. Under a rural it comes Jilla Parishad, Panchayat Samiti and Grama Panchayat. Jilla Parishad you call it as at the district level, Panchayat Samiti at block level, and Grama Panchayat at the village level. In urban areas you call it as towns and cities. Towns you call as municipalities and cities you call as municipal corporations. Thank you.